Talk about the mean and median of a distribution. So first let's talk about a simple example. Here's some five numbers here, values. And the average of those, the mean, is you sum them all up and divide by how many there are. So that adds up to 100 divided by 5, 20. So the average is 20. But that doesn't really represent that distribution that well. You know, most of the numbers are smaller down here. It's only this one up here that's pulling the mean forward or up. So 20 doesn't represent the data very well, just as when you have LeBron James on your NBA team. You know, he's one of the best, or the best, basketball player in the world right now. His salary is so high compared to everyone else on the team that it pulls the team average up too high and gives a false impression of a player's typical salary. So sometimes we need a different measure of the center of the data, rather than just the mean, because the mean might be giving us a false impression. So we go to the median. The median is the middle value in the distribution. If you lay out all the values in the distribution from smallest to largest in order, then the middle value, or the average between the two middle ones, if there's not an actual middle count one, that's going to be the median. So the median is a value inside the distribution somewhere, such that 50% of the data are below that value and 50% is above. So let's say you have a P of X density function for the distribution. Then if you add up all the area from negative infinity up to the median, you should get 50%, or 0.5. And also, if you go from the median and add up all the area the rest of to infinity, you should add up with 50% also. Okay? Of course, the mean can coincide with the median, such as in a normal distribution. In the normal distribution, it's a bell-shaped curve type. And of course, halfway it's 0.5 and 0.5, and the mean is there, and the median's there. So that can happen, but it doesn't always happen. If your distribution's like this, then your mean is pulled forward or more because of these large values down here. They're very large out there, but most of your data is in here, so the median is going to be somewhere around in there, the median. So they can be apart, or they can be synced up as in a symmetric bell-shaped curve. Okay, so that was the general picture for the median. Wherever it is, half of the area is below the median and half of the area is above. So that's where you get your calculus formulas for that. Now, how do we find the mean? Okay, let's just say there's a lot of values there. I'm trying to get rid of this thing. Okay. So let's talk about the heights of adults that are over 20 years of age in the US. So the mean would just simply be summing up all the heights of all the people and dividing by the number of people. Okay, so let's just do this a more sophisticated way. Let's set f of x is the density function for the heights of the people. And The number, then, therefore, of people with heights between height x and height x plus delta x. X is a height. That would be the percent of people with those heights from x to x plus delta x. But that's just the density times the width of that interval. Because when you times those together, you get the area, which does represent the number of people with those heights. And so if that's the percentage of the people with the heights, and you multiply by a total number of people, you're going to get the number of people with the heights between x and x plus delta x. So if you had 100 people and 10% of them were between x and x plus delta x, then you would have 10% of 100, which is 10 people between x and x plus delta x in height. So here's a little picture for that. Your density is your f of x value from here to here. The range of values is your x to x plus delta x, and the area, the product of those two, the f of x times delta x, represents the area, which is the percent of people with heights between x and x plus delta x. So those amount of people all have height x, essentially. Of course, some of them have heights between x and x plus delta x, but as x delta x goes down to zero, you're just going to be sitting there in the limit with that one value x as their height. So they all essentially have height x. So if you want the sum of all the heights of those people between x and plus delta x, you'll have the height value times the number of people with that height value. And that'll give you the sum of all the heights. So now we want the sum of the heights of all the people in the entire U.S. So that would be summing up all those individual sums of heights from the people between x and with heights between x and x plus delta x. And I can factor out that n. And that sum's going to go over all the x values from negative infinity to infinity. Now, of course, nobody has negative height. So this density function would be structured such that it was zero all the way up to the smallest value height, and zero after the largest value height. So we could still integrate it and add it up from negative infinity to infinity. It's just that a lot of those would be zeros. So as delta x goes to zero, we then have in the limit that the sum of heights of all the people are this integral. And so the mean is the sum of the heights of all the people over the number of people. And we just got through saying that the sum of heights of all the people was this part, and the number of total people is this. So these n's cancel out, and you get this integral here. And that's your formula for the average of a distribution. The mean of a distribution, given a density function f of x, it's just integral from negative infinity to infinity of x f of x delta x.